Hi everyone, Lisa Resnick with The Real Tea. I am with Barb Ewing with the
Youngstown Business Incubator.
Yes, she is the Chief Executive Director of YBI, which we often hear that's the name that it's referred to, which I do love the acronym for it as well. Flows very well.
Thank you. We spent a lot of time talking about our brand and the recognition that we have. So it's good to hear that. I'll add that to the list of things to consider. So it's definitely a strong brand.
It is a strong brand. And for all those out there, can you give us a little bit of a history of the Youngstown Business Incubator?
Sure. We were established right around the year 2000, a little bit before that, as a general purpose incubator. So we could work with any company that came knocking on our door. So, you know, very traditional businesses. But right around the year 2001, the state created the Ohio Edison program, which was to really spur technology development. And at that time, they said if we wanted to continue to get state funding, we needed to align with one of the technologies that they were trying to grow in Ohio. So at the time, we picked software and became a very successful organization building software companies. It actually led to the model that we have, which is to try to create a cluster downtown, talking about real estate, and to really create something where the whole is greater than the sum of the parts. So we didn't want to graduate our tenants out and have them scattered all over. I mean, we didn't want to graduate our portfolio companies, our successful portfolio companies out and have them scattered all over the valley. We wanted to keep them nestled together downtown.
So that's definitely a good idea to do it that way.
Yeah, it just really changes everything. I mean, having developers talking to other developers, just creating connections, creating synergies. There's really great value there when you're able to have that type of an ecosystem.
There's a lot of value. And I know this with other cities too, depending on where you are, what little ecosystem you are, you do reference it to, well, this is the government section of town. And this is your portfolio with architects or your back in the day, the computers, or what were they called? What was it? What was that day and age where you had your techies?
Oh, well, software, IT, I'm not sure which.
With their trendy, fun office space.
Oh, yeah. and actually, I'm not sure what word you're looking for there, but I mean, we really do try to keep that going on. And I mean, our office space is always brightly colored and great, you know, as much lighting as we can get, and, you know, try to do fun events on campus and just make it a place where people want to be.
I love the fact that you just used the word campus, because that is what you guys are establishing downtown.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, we've got 5 buildings, more than 200,000 square feet, and probably are one of the largest landlords downtown. I don't, you know, some of those buildings are pretty big, so hard to compete with the city of Youngstown, obviously. With
you are a major player when it comes to downtown real estate, for sure. You really are.
We are really deeply committed to the city of Youngstown and helping to spur its redevelopment, and feel very passionately that having that campus downtown is part of our DNA. It's part of who we are.
That's right.
We would not want to be a virtual organization because there would be so much loss there. And on the software side, it is a little easier to have those remote companies, but working both with our traditional businesses through our Minority Business Assistance Center. So, you know, we service minorities, women, veterans, even have a youth program. Those companies definitely, you know, look for opportunities to get office space where they can be part of something larger. And we're hoping that as this year unfolds, we can begin to bring those types of businesses more to our campus. And then on our additive manufacturing side, having that cluster is really important. So as you know, in our 4th building, we have America Makes, the National Lab for Additive Manufacturing. I think you know something about that.
I may, just a little.
So we'll let everybody else in on the joke. Lisa's husband works there. It's not bad form to have private jokes.
No, not at all.
But that really spurred a change in YBI. We started to develop programs to work with additive manufacturing companies, both startups and also existing businesses, to help them learn how to integrate additive. And so the most recent award that we have, what sparked this conversation, was the fact that we're getting $2 million from the feds to finish the renovations to the original Vindicator building. So,
which also should let people know out there how much it does cost to redevelop buildings and make sure that this, like, the infrastructure plus the glitz and glam is all able to get done in the way that it needs to be done.
Oh yeah. And the $2 million is only 80% of the cost of the project. We still have to go back and get the remaining 20%. So when we started the project last year, we were estimating that the total cost would be about 2.3, 2.4. But with the recent rise in construction costs, knocking on wood on that, because that could be a significant emotional event.
Yes. Well, hopefully those construction costs are starting to slow down in their increase.
I hope.
And actually then more competition for them does occur, that the prices start to get a little bit lower. They're not going to be as low as they were in 2019, but maybe a little bit less of a sticker shock when you get those numbers.
And we're 6 months away from, probably 6 months away from being able to actually start the project, because there's still,
that works in your favor.
Yeah, still reams of paperwork to go through at the state level. And we are still fundraising for the remaining 20%. We're committed to the project, but we still are trying to raise the dollars to finish the build out. So
now you mentioned assistance for minorities, women. So when you talk about assistance, because it's not just, hey, it's like from the ground up, you're assisting local entrepreneurs that are trying to create more business downtown or surrounding areas.
Right. Our tagline is elevating every entrepreneur. And we are trying to work with, we're trying to remove the silos between our programs as much as possible. I mean, there are realities there of how dollars can be spent, but we want to be a resource for every business in the Valley. Have the ability to flex and work with anybody who wants to start a car washing business to, again, starting a new software company or an advanced materials company. The level of entrepreneurship in this region and across the Midwest is just lower than it is in the rest of the country. So we need really to get every player on the field. If somebody is even having an inkling about starting a business, we want to first off encourage them to do so, but also give them the tools to be successful.
I agree completely with you. I think that if you have a thought in your mind about creating something, don't let it just remain a thought. Let that be the seed for it to grow, and speak with other people. Find out what other avenues that need to be taken for you to achieve what you want.
Absolutely. It is really tough for people to go it alone. And it's so common to see companies make really fundamental mistakes early on that can hurt them for the rest of their business's life. And in some instances, extinguish that life. It's a great but yet terrible example. On our software side, there's a company that not realizing what they were doing had a lot of small investors. And when it came time to try to do another round of funding, larger investors weren't interested in trying to negotiate those waters. It was just it really discouraged a lot of outside investors from looking hard at that potential deal. And it's something that would have been avoidable had we been able to engage with them earlier.
That's right. And I always say I would never want to be one man on an island.
That is the truth. I mean, you don't know what you don't know. And even if you work in an industry, if you may know the technical side of how to be a baker or how to be an accountant or anything. You may know all of those types of things, but really understanding how to structure that business and understand how to market it and the cost of doing business and all of the things that you need to factor in order to really be successful and make money, that's a whole different thing. So technical knowledge is the basis of your business, but it's not going to build your business.
That's completely accurate. And even if you were well-versed in your field, there is still always something new that comes about that there's still opportunity to learn. There's never not an opportunity to learn and to grow and expand. There's just not.
Right. And if you believe that you are at that point, then you probably should hang it up because you're going to get into trouble. You're just absolutely going to get into trouble.
Yes.
The world changes, rules change. I mean, you see it all the time. A disruptive technology comes in and shakes the market up, but they don't stay on top of their own industry. And then somebody comes up behind them and shakes it up all over again. So you can never rest on your laurels.
No, never. And you guys, as I mentioned before, are a major stakeholder of real estate in downtown Youngstown. You are also an economic spur. Besides just owning the buildings, residing in these buildings, you are stimulating the economy at the same time of that market. Like, you guys are a pretty powerful force for sure.
We try to be diverse in trying to find new ways to add capacity to the community, build new partnerships, create new programs to support economic development. So we both work with our own startups locally, but we also work very hard to attract people to our campus. And so, you know, we recently announced a partnership with the University of Texas at El Paso that will bring interns onto our campus to do research on a specific project that involves additive manufacturing that was funded through an earmark or through congressionally directed funding from Congressman Ryan's office and Congresswoman Escobar in Texas. We've got our additively manufactured eyeglass company, Fitz Frames.
That's
right. Company is founded in California. The founders are located on the East Coast and the West Coast, but the company is located in Youngstown. They manufacture eyeglasses and, they're building that business here. Also have Heyday Health, our newest portfolio company. It's a telehealth company, primary care physicians for people 65 and older. Again, founders are not local, but the employees are. So,
it's amazing.
Yeah. We're always trying to find another opportunity to create jobs and bring people back to the region. I mean, part of our goal is always to find people who left and would like to come back home and raise their family here. You know, maybe they left after college, but now they're married and have a couple kids and want to be, want their parents to be around to be a babysitter. So, yes. You know, we do a lot to try to build our network so that we can reach out to those people and find opportunities to bring them home for positions that are being created.
Well, I think it's been said many, many times, but we are very lucky in our area to have YBI. A lot
Thank
of
you.
Other cities do not have that opportunity. And for all those entrepreneurs out there that are looking for help, or anybody with an idea that are looking for somebody to help guide them to make it more tangible, how do they reach out to you?
Well, the easiest way is through our website. So www.ybi.org, O-R-G, not com. That's really the easiest way. I mean, there is a landline that they can go through, and I'll give that slowly. It's 330-746-5003. We try to connect people through the website as much as possible because it allows us to help them find the right staff person. And the thing that I would add is that especially today, we no longer work just with startups. So we will try to work with any business at any stage. We did a lot of work during the pandemic trying to connecting companies to PPP, and we all of the programs that we offer on things like social media and marketing or understanding your financials are available not just to startups, but to any business in the region. And they're generally also now available online. So if you don't have time to come out, you can find those things archived.
Well, that is awesome. And I hope that the Realty can get a tour.
Absolutely. You let me know.
All right. That's great. Thank you so much. All right. I really appreciate your time. And I really appreciate everything that the Youngstown Business Incubator does for our area. And
well, thank you. Thank you so much. All right. Absolutely.
Get more grant money.
We're always looking for more grant money.
All right.
Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thanks for watching the video. Be sure to like, subscribe, and hit that little bell for notifications. And also make sure to connect with us on Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn. For all of your business news, visit businessjournaldaily.com. For all of your arts and entertainment news, go to afterhoursyoungstown.com.